गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, वेलकम टू महिला समाज ऑनलाइन डिजिटल क्लासेस। हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप ऑल आर सेफ एट होम। होप यू ऑल एंजॉयड योर दसरा हॉलीडेज चिल्ड्रन। क्लास 7, सब्जेक्ट सोशल साइंस, टॉपिक नॉर्थ अमेरिका। सो चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज़ द कंटिन्यूएशन पार्ट ऑफ नॉर्थ अमेरिका। So, in our previous classes, we have discussed about the location, physical settings, and natural resources of North America. So, today, let us learn much more about North America. Coming to agriculture. Agriculture is an important occupation of North America. Central lowlands of the continent, especially Canada and USA, are very productive agricultural countries. So, Canada and USA are very productive agricultural countries. Only 10% of the total area of North America is suitable for agriculture. But the production from their farms is very high. So, children, only 10% of the area in North America is suitable for agriculture. Even then, the production from the farm is very high because large farms, rich soil, adequate irrigation, mechanized farming, other facilities with human efforts make North America one of the largest agricultural region of the world. So, because of the large farms, rich soil and adequate irrigation and using of the mechanized farming methods, so with all this, the effort, human effort, which is very important, so makes the North America one of the largest agricultural region of the world. So, region specialized in the production of specific crops. So, are called as crop belt. Corn belt, wheat belt, cotton belt, tobacco belt, etc. So, here, very important children, wheat is one of the popular cereals grown in the North America. So, especially in Canada and USA. Okay? So, since the population is low, lot of surplus production is obtained which can be exported. Another crop is maize. Maize is popularly known as corn. So, it is grown extensively in the United States and Mexico. So, most of the maize is used as feed crops for feeding cattle and pigs. So, maize is used for the feeding of the cattle and pigs. So, they are reared for meat in Mexico. So, these cattle are reared for the purpose of meat. Maize is the staple food grain, but today maize is grown as a check crop. So apart from that, the other popular crops are barley, oat and potato. Barley and oat can be grown in the cold weather. Beer is brewed from barley. Oats is used as a feeding crop for the animals. Potato is also grown in the continent which serves as food crop. So here oats is used for feeding the animals and potato is grown which serves as a food crop. Apart from this, cotton and tobacco are also grown. So children, cotton and tobacco are cash crops. Okay, so the cotton belt lies along the Mississippi Valley. USA and Mexico are important producers of long staple cotton. So cotton is grown in USA and Mexico. Tobacco grown in the South USA, Cuba, Jamaica and Mexico. The USA ranks second after China among the major tobacco growing countries of the world. So USA ranks second. So the first is China. So USA ranks second in growing the tobacco. Not only cotton, tobacco, even sugar cane, it is also one of the important crop grown here. So Cuba is the third largest producer of sugar in the world. So popularly it is called as the sugar bowl of the world. Sugar beet is also grown in the USA and it is a major source of making sugar after sugar cane. So here in the picture you can observe the crops. Apart from cotton, tobacco, sugarcane, another important cash crop is coffee and coca. So these are tropical plantation crops. So which is grown in the parts of Central America and West Indies. Fruits like grapes, oranges, lime, apple, pears, peaches, etc. are also grown in California, Florida, New Jersey and areas around urban centers. So apart from these, fruits like grapes, oranges, lime, apple, pears, peaches are also grown. So California produces 90% of the wine. You all know, children, wine is produced by using the grapes in North America. Therefore, California is called the wine country. Okay, children. So California is called as the wine country. So here important is Cuba is called as a sugar bowl of the world. California is called as the wine country. Shallow continental streams such as Grand Banks, George Banks of the New England and Newfoundland coast are popular fishing grounds. So now let us look into the important minerals and industries. So North America is blessed with abundant resources. So its natural resources are variety of soils, extensive grasslands, minerals, power resources and forest wealth. So that is why it is blessed with the abundant resources. So the continent has rich deposits of different valuable minerals. Now let us see which are the minerals. So the deposits of gold had once attracted people to this continent. Besides this, iron ore, copper, nickel, silver and zinc are other major mineral deposits. So the continent also abounds in coal, petroleum and natural gas. So these are the minerals. Gold. So now look at the picture, children. Here you can see silver, gold, copper and iron ore. So gold. Gold is very first mineral mined in North America. So California and Yukon valleys are important areas of gold mines. Lake Superior and its surrounding areas are known for having large deposits of iron ore. So Lake Superior and its surrounding area have large deposits of iron ore. So the high grade iron ore is found in and around the Canadian Shield. So high grade of iron is found in the Canadian Shield. So Mexico is the world's major producer of silver. So Mexico is the major producer of silver. Okay, children. And then the USA is the leading producer of copper in the world. So USA is the leading producer of copper in the world, and it is also mined in Canada. Okay. Fossil fuels are exploited in considerable quantities throughout the continent. So North America has large deposits of high-grade cooking coal. Okay, children. And then, so USA is the world's largest coal exporter. Oil and natural gas are found in Alaska, Texas, Louisiana, Kansas, and in Western Canada and parts of Mexico. So the USA is the major producer of petroleum, and USA is the leading producer of nuclear power in the world. Among the countries of North America, USA and Canada are highly industrialized. Availability of raw materials like iron ore, coal, copper, bauxite helps heavy industries, and availability of power, transport and modern technology has helped industrialization to a great extent. The lake region of Air Superior and Michigan have seen a lot of development in iron and steel industry. Raw materials and water transport have helped tremendously. So the favorable industrial policy of USA has helped in the growth of industries. So it is very important, children. The lake region of Air, so you can see in the picture, children. So it has helped in the tremendous growth of the industries. The city of Pittsburgh is called the Steel City because due to the rich coal deposits found here, and also hydroelectric power and easy transport facilities for bulk materials. Iron and steel is the basic industry, so it helps for the growth of other industries like automobile, shipbuilding, locomotives, heavy engineering, aircraft, etc. Apart from this, wood pulp, paper and newsprint are produced in the USA and Canada. So soft wood is used for making the paper, pulp, cardboard and newsprint. So pulp is also used to produce synthetic fiber. So Canada is one of the top exporters of paper, pulp and newsprints. So lumbering is a highly organized job in North America. So the people engaged in lumbering in Canada are known as lumberjacks. So one of the important industries is the chemical industry, which produces a variety of articles like synthetic rubber, plastics, fertilizers and medicines. So plastic have now replaced by wood to a great extent. Plastic is prepared in all parts of the USA. Chicago is famous for plastic industry. So now let us look into the electrical and electronic goods. So it is a largest producer of the electrical and electronic goods. So it is produced on a large scale. Here you can find many of the industrial products and machineries are exported from USA and Canada. Mexico and other countries in Central America lag behind in industrial development. Most of these countries are small and do not have adequate power resource and raw materials needed for industrial development. So, now let us know about the population. Most of the North Americans are descendants of Europeans, of American, Indians and Africans. Although there are some native people, most of them speak Spanish, English, French or American Indian languages. So population density is the highest in the highlands of Mexico and Central America, but much of the northern part of the continent is also empty, especially the frozen far north. So, the densely populated parts of USA are urban centers and industrial regions. Nearly 98% of the population is urban in North America. The population of the Caribbean islands is less, but settlement is dense. This due to the limited availability of land. So children, with this we have covered the topic North America. So I have given you a simple question children. Write a note on population of North America. So read the question, watch the video till end and answer to the given question. Hope you enjoyed and understood the topic. Let us meet in the next class with a new topic. Till then, stay home, stay safe, have a great day, children. Thank you.